Magandang hapon po, Sir Echo. Welcome po sa Tatak UPLB segment. Bago tayo mag-umpisa ng ating kwentuhan, pwede mo bang batiin ang mga nanonood ng ating programa?
Okay, magandang hapon din, Polly, no? And thank you for allowing me to be here. And just want to say hi for the followers of Galang UPLB, especially this segment, Tatak UPLB segment. I hope you will have fun hearing from us and learning from us.
Umpisahan natin sa iyong student life. So, Sir Echo, nung panahon mo ba? Paano ka ba namili ng iyong magiging course?
Parang kailan lang actually, no? So, as I look back, I was reminded na I was not really intended to be with the economics program, no? So, initially, what I really want is to be in a course that is related to IT and to any life sciences course. And then eventually, an opportunity came up, which is this economics program. And sabi ko pa sa sarili ko, sige, pagbigyan ko na lang to, and then eventually transfer na lang ako. Pero eventually, when I got into the course, I had so many realizations. I appreciate more the course. And eventually, it opened a new path in my life. Meaning, bigla ko na-realize na, I like this path pala na it's not just really about economics, no, but it's really more of making me to be a better decision maker in life and at work. Actually, it's not really about me. It's really on how I can contribute to the development process. So, yun yung nag-igting talaga sa akin. Kasi you know naman na as UP students, no, we have that passion and desire to really help the country. So, with that course, I believe that I can better contribute to the development of the country.
Meron po ba kayong natatandaan na hindi mo makakalimutan na professor or subject noong panahon mo?
Actually, there's a lot of unforgettable things, no? Especially for my program. But siguro, syempre, we don't want to name drop na lang, no? And siguro, I will give you the course na lang, no? It's an econ course. What made it unforgettable for me is that nung una kasi around 30 plus kami sa klase na yon, and then sa sobrang hirap ng course naging 7 na lang kami, so the others dropped, the others really gave up, surrendered, kasi ibang klase talaga yung expectations and the like, no? But ako actually I'm not really having anything against the professor. For me, I see it as an opportunity for me to learn better and for me to be motivated better. Kasi aside from the very high turnover rate ng klase, no, it motivated me to really strive better for that course. Kasi imagine na, that's my first subject that I have a failing mark for the first exam. For the record, that's the first time in my whole UPLB life. And sabi ko that time, teka, give up na ba ako? Kasi it's only the first exam, di ba? Pero after that, I really strived hard for that exam and that the course na itself. And hindi ako nagkaroon ng galit or pot doon sa professor. It really made me push my limits and really do well for that course. And yun, eventually, I'm one of the 7 students who passed that course during that semester. And I will never really forget that. But those students who are planning to take econ, don't be discouraged. Of course, that is an isolated case, I hope. At the personal level, no, aside from the knowledge and skills, no, that I acquired for that course, it's really more of being more holistic on how I approach learning. Kasi aside from me doing it individually, alam mo yun, nagkaroon kami ng more solid tie with my classmates, with my other 6 classmates, no? Kasi talagang tulong-tulong, and alam mo yun, parang todo na to, let's help each other out. So parang dumating sa point na we do a lot of group studies, we really remind ourselves on what to do and what the best techniques to consider, the best practices, no? So, aside from the passing the course talaga, it also made me to be more relational, no? And alam mo yung value friendships and the people, and madadala mo yun up until work, eh. It's somehow a team spirit, no? And na yun, na parang they are also one of the sources of my encouragement during those times.
Ngayon naman, sir, despite everything that happened, at the end of your graduation, nalaman mo na magna cum laude ka. Anong pakiramdam mo noon? And ito ba ay talagang naging goal mo nung estudyante ka?
Hindi pa rin ako makapaniwala, kumbaga. Kasi first, it's not really my goal, no? Even having that valedictory address for my college, no? It was really not part of the plan. What I only intend to is to finish the course well kasi I have a number of scholarships. And of course, when you have your scholarship, you need to have a maintaining grade. I have a lot of fear during those times, no? Especially to math. Imagine, econ course yun. So we will deal a lot with math, no? And nung high school kasi ako in elementary, medyo allergic talaga ako sa math. And sabi ko sa sarili, paano ko to ano malalampasan, no? So what I did is, I really strive hard to do better, no? For my math courses. And di ko lubos akalain na medyo nasobrahan ko ata yung pagtuon ng pansin sa mga math courses tayo. And then eventually, alam mo yun, nung nakita ko nga yung value ng course and then yung impact noon after graduation, parang nagkaroon ako ng passion and desire to really finish the course well. And without even me tracking my grades or whatsoever. Ano kasi eh, aside from the scholarship, there's a lot of people who believes in me. So sila talaga yung nag-push sa akin to do better. And sabi ko nga sarili ko, bonus na lang if I will have that Latin honors. Yeah. And bukang bibig ko talaga sa mga kaibigan at kapamilya ko that time is that, this is not actually a part of the plan. And nung nalaman ko nga na I have that Latin honor, parang mas pinagmamalaki ko siguro yung mga tao behind all of those. And all the lessons learned.
Ano ba yung pinili mong career?
My first career path, no, actually is not really into agriculture. But well, somehow related, no? Kasi I started my career at the education sector, no? Specifically at DepEd. More on planning, more on governance, no? More on operations for the education sector, no? Meron din ako mga nakilala na ag-econ, ano, graduates in that department. But I have that deep desire kasi talaga on the education sector after graduation. And I also have a person that I know well, no, in the department that I believe has really a passion for development work. He motivated me, no, to be at the education sector. And actually, I was one of the pioneers, no, in terms of the senior high school program, no. I'm part of that team, no. Eventually, I got the general feel, no, of the challenges and the concerns of the education sector. And then after that, nasa education sector pa rin ako, but really more on training development. Kasi another passion of mine is to do training, capacity building. I really want to teach even before college. Through that, napagpatuloy ko yung path ko in that sector. After that, I had this opportunity to work with the infrastructure sector, specifically at the National Economic Development Authority through its attached agency, the PPP Center. No? So ngayon, what I did at the education sector, na-apply ko in the infrastructure sector in terms of planning, in terms of capacity building as well. And nakita ko na all of them are interconnected. Eh. Though I did not really enter the agriculture sector, but I know that those things that I did at the education sector and at the infrastructure sector will have an impact to the agricultural sector. No? Especially ngayon, nung kasagsagan ng Build program, no? Doon ko talaga nakita yung kahalagahan ng infrastruktura for the agriculture sector. So, alam mo yun, ganun yung naging path and unexpected siya. But at the same time, it's fulfilling because you know that you're contributing something for the development of the country. No? So, andun lagi yung calling ko and desire ko to do something for the development sector as a whole. And alam mo naman, di ba, bilang mga escorts ka, di ba, nananalaytay talaga sa mga dugo natin ng pagiging makabayan, di ba? So the more that I have that deeper desire, no, to really help our countrymen through the development work. Currently, I'm with the National Economic and Development Authority, no, sa PPP Center or the Public-Private Partnership Center. What I really do is on the planning side. So I'm with the corporate planning and we monitor the performance of the agency in terms of its targets. Nandun din kami sa larangan ng performance management na kung saan inaalam namin kung we're still on the right track. And we also do process improvement na kung ano bang kailangan nating ayusin pa sa ating mga proseso, sa ating mga standard, no? And a lot of other things pa.
Ano ba sa tingin mo mga katangian dapat ng isang Tatak UPLB?
Poli, siguro alam mo naman yung panatang makabayan. Noona, nire-recite ko lang siya kasi for compliance, no? But eventually, as I grow old, doon ko talaga na-realize yung bandang dulo, no, na it really matters as UPLB students, yung sinasabi nilang maka-Diyos, makatao, makakalikasan at makabansa. So for me, it's really resounding, no, whenever I look back. Hindi lang siya a matter of words, no. It's really something that should be innate, no, not just for UPLB students but for the Filipino nation as a whole.
And ano po bang pwede niyong ma-advise na dito sa mga incoming freshies natin?
Okay, aside from doing well at their pre-rog activities, to be serious on this one, no. Ako kasi even during my college life, no, I really have a lot of questions in mind, no. And of course, up until now naman, I'm still a work in progress and I cannot really say to you that I really did well in all aspects of my life. But ako siguro what my key takeaway, no, as I go through life up until now is first is for us to have a vision. Napakahalaga ng vision, no. You need to ask yourself, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, what would I really be? Okay? Kasi whenever you get discouraged or distraught, you need to go back to that vision, no? Para kung sakali you're confused or hindi mo na alam kung tama pa ba 'tong decision mo, whenever you go back to your vision, you will be guided, diba? So, 'yun yung up until now dala-dala ko, no, whenever I ask myself, teka, ano na bang next? What will be next, no? As long as it's aligned with my vision, things will be better. Things will be okay. Second one is relationships. In this life, there's a lot of relationships, no, even during college days, no. And definitely, you will have a lot of that. Lalo na kapag into organizations kayo, joining other extracurricular activities at in college, no. But even at the workplace, no, and even in your family life, no, relationships really matter. And it's really important to have those circle, no, that will really stay by your side, no, and not just by your side but will also help you be better as a person, no, and as a colleague as well. And it's not just getting something from them, but also you giving something to them, no. Minsan it takes alam mo yun, just listening to them and valuing what they thought, no, or what they think about life, no. Malaki na yung impact nun, eh. And remember sa buhay estudyante, mental health is really really important, no. So with that kind of circles or relationship, good influences, no, that can help you grow. I think you will finish gracefully at the university, no. And lastly, ito, I think medyo cliche na to, but I really want to emphasize is that you don't never ever lose hope, no matter what. And I think the very important thing here is the source of hope. So you need to know that. And for me, that source of hope is a person, and that's no other than Jesus Christ himself. So ako, if you have that faith that everything will get better, no, or kung hindi man na dito sa mundong to, you know that one day, no, the things you prayed for, the things you dream of will eventually get answered. Ako, I'm always looking at the brighter side of things, and I know that a better plan and a good plan is there for me. Ayun lang yung gusto kong i-end for the students, no, UPLB. Aside from honor and excellence, no, I think those are the things that we need to be reminded of every day.
Other than that, sir, syempre, hindi kita pakakawalan nang hindi mo ginagawa ang aming favorite request sa aming mga alumni dito sa segment ng Tatak. Syempre, ang ating Tatak shoutout. Sir, pwede ba naming marinig ang inyong version ng Tatak shoutout?
Ako si Jericho Gala. Tatak UPLB ako.